Hi, I'm Rhys Dunlop.
And I am Alan Mahon. I play Steve.
And I play Lad. Lad is the voice of masculinity inside Steve's head.
As boys, we were both conditioned by society to be men, hearing phrases like boys don't cry or man up.
And we think that this upbringing creates a little voice inside men's heads, making sure that we don't stray too far from these masculine ideals. I don't know why, in case we turn into a woman or something.
But underneath this brash surface, there's this soft heart of a lonely person trying to figure out their place in the world. So, the plot. Steve is trying to write a best man speech, and his lad isn't helping.
And then, you bend her over the top table, grab her by that fancy mother of the groom hat she has on, and start fucking...
Magic dance face.
Girls who wear hats, love it.
Steve's best friend, Dan, is getting married in 2 weeks' time, but Steve doesn't have a best man speech and doesn't have a date to the wedding. Dan mentions that the maid of honour, Jenny...
Jenny? I wonder if it ends with a Y or with an I. Girls with names end in an I. Love it!
Jenny doesn't have a date yet either, and Dan sets them up together. They go to the zoo. Steve loves animals and is thinking about applying for a job in the zoo. The date goes well.
After you reveal to Jenny that the okapi's tongue can grow up to 45 centimetres in length, she said, and I quote, "Give me a go on the okapi."
That was a joke!
Steve gets an interview for the job at the zoo, and Jenny works as a recruiter, so she helps him prepare for it.
Do you have a date to the wedding yet? This is your chance, ask her!
No, I don't have one, not yet.
What are you doing? Just checking to see where it's gone.
The interview goes well, and Steve meets up with Jenny for a date at her house.
I'm 6 months too.
If you tell her that, I'll take your penis and throw it in the bin.
6 months isn't that long.
Yeah, not for a woman.
Between ourselves, I'm...
Steve!
It's actually been a few months for me too.
Steven!
Six as well.
Why don't you want to have sex with this woman?
Exactly, just a bit of a dry spell.
Don't cheers to that.
To her dry spell. Yeah, and to an ending soon.
Oh, hang on.
Just as it's looking like Steve is learning to ignore Lad, he receives a rejection email from the job he's applied for at the zoo. And to add to this humiliation, he receives the email in front of the lads.
So Lad tells him it was Jenny's fault that she gave him bad interview advice.
She set you up to fail. You did exactly what she told
you to do and you didn't get the job.
And then Lad goes a little bit further.
She's a female supremacist. You're lucky you got out when you did.
And then...
Now, he's on the hunt for a sexual partner.
And then they decide that it would be a good idea to send Jenny a photo of Steve kissing this random girl. And then the next morning, he meets up with Dan.
Am I in a fit state to be best man? Well, let me tell you, Dan, it's not going to be a problem. I'd be embarrassed to be best man at your sham of a wedding. So you know what you can do? You can take your tampon out and shove your wedding up your fucking hole.
And at rock bottom, Steve decides that maybe Lad isn't really a good influence on him and tries to fight his lad.
It doesn't go well.
Oh, I don't know, Steve. Answer him. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm...
A wretched waste of spunk.
I'm
a... A pathetic failure.
I'm...
Absolutely nothing!
I'm okay!
And finally, Steve opens up to Dan about how he knows he's been a prick lately and... Well, it's very emotional. Very well acted.
And I'm sorry that I told you to take your tampon in and shove your wedding up your fucking arm.
And then he goes to the wedding, and he decides to try and reframe his relationship with his own masculinity. And it's very powerful.
Very.
So, that's it.
Thanks for watching.